If you've taken a DNA test, it is time to ignore your ethnicity matches and start processing your DNA cousin match. The most fun in genetic genealogy is not trying to figure out what percentage of DNA you have from Ireland or Wales, but rather to figure out how your genetic relatives are related to you and each other. Now, if you're just beginning in genetic genealogy research, I hope that you will find the tools on Ancestry fairly easy to understand and use. So let me walk you through what I do when I'm working on my DNA matches. So first, I go to the Ancestry website, and then I click on DNA, and I click on DNA matches. There's other things you can look at. This is what I want to focus on. So when I come to the DNA matches, I first try to see, do I recognize anybody on this profile? Now this is a profile for my cousin, and notice you see me. So let's go fix that profile to say, yeah, my cousin knows how I am related to them. So what I want to do is I want to click on this button that says, do you recognize them? Yes, I do. So the next thing I need to do after I recognize somebody is say, are we related on the maternal side or the paternal side? Well, this is actually a relative from my maternal side, and my match, I am a match through her maternal side. So we can go ahead and do that. So if it's you to that person, you need to decide which way it goes. If that person to you, you need to make sure it goes, because if this match If I was related through her father, then I would have to click father's side. You could do both sides, and there is times when you're related to both sides, and there is the option of I'm not sure. And to me, that confuses me at this stage a little bit. So if you're not sure, just don't do this. So I'm going to go ahead and click mother's side. Now I can select the relationship assignment. So I have a number of options here that I can choose from. And our relationship could be first cousin, but that's not exactly how we are related. So I'm going to click down here and I'm going to choose something differently. This is actually that relationship, and go ahead and click confirm. Now there are some times when you're going to be related to somebody. So I'm a first cousin one time removed with this person. Why is it less than 1%? I can tell you that as I have begun using this tool on my family tree, I know genealogically and genetically that a number of these people are related to me in these lower percentages, these less 1%, this all of these different relationships that seem a little small. Now, the closer you are to that person, you really should be up here in the 99% tile. But with your second, third, fourth, and fifth cousin or cousin equivalent designations, then the percentages were smaller. And that is okay. If you know that's how that relationship is, go ahead and select it. So here's a different one. They are definitely quite far removed. The predicted relationship was fourth to sixth cousin. And as you can see, well, there's a 33% chance this is your third cousin. And then it gets smaller and smaller. But let's say they're fifth cousin once removed or something like that. Then you would have to select this option of distant relationship. But typically, as I'm going through the do you recognize, I recognize more closer relationships. So I go ahead and do the people I recognize first. Now, the next thing I do is I go through and I begin analyzing my DNA matches that have trees online. It's really hard to figure out how people are related if they don't share their trees online with you. You actually can try to figure out how they're related if the trees they share are fairly small, but it's best if we start with the people who have shared their trees so we can see how we're related. So I have a match and I'm going to click on common ancestors. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. So I'm on the tree of the first to second cousin, and the first thing I'm going to look for is this common ancestor toolbox. When I click view relationship, it looks very much like this. That DNA match is matched through her mother to George Joseph Geisler and back down through her uncle to her first cousin. If that looks accurate and I can validate it with other sources in addition to DNA, then I can go ahead and go to the next step. Now, for more complicated through lines where you pass through multiple people and some of these people say evaluate, 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 and then there's actually another another person down here. If you pass through the evaluation, that's going to take a little bit more genealogical research for you to go through, and that's fine. But once you have decided, yeah, I know how these people are related, then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go and I'm going to do the add relationship, just like we did earlier. So once again, I can come in, and because that was a maternal ancestor, I can click on maternal, and then I can click on first cousin, and then there will be a confirm button for me to use. So the next thing I can do with this match is I can add a note. Okay? For my closest matches, I tend not to do any notes. But for the more distant matches, I do notes, and we'll come back to that in just a moment. As you can see here, I began processing a lot of my close relatives. I do put dots, and we'll come to that in just a moment. After I get through the list of close matches, then it's time to work on the extended family. So one of the things I do next, after I do the who do I recognize, I go to filter by common ancestors with trees, and then I go find a more distant relative. So I'm going to pick this one. Now, what's really exciting about this tree is the relative is connected through my German immigrant ancestor, Joseph Geisler, and his first wife, Caroline Mock. Yes! And because this is my cousin, I'm able to go pick up DNA matches that I don't match. So I don't actually match this person. So I'm going to go ahead and click View Relationship. My cousin and her match are related through Joseph Geisler. So in my tree, this is my cousin's mother. This is our shared ancestor, George Joseph Geisler. I'm related to my cousin through here. And then all of these people are already in my tree. That's because they're all white. Okay, and this is a through line, right? But it's not the massive through lines where we would see all the extra people and how they're related. But this is just a through line between two people. Because what happens is the DNA match has Thelma in their tree, and I don't have Thelma in my cousin's tree. And so we would have to go evaluate and see if Thelma works, if that relationship's right. And once we do that, then we have some work to do. So I'm going to go back to the profile, and I'm going to add a relationship. This is Nancy's mother's side. This is a third cousin down here. And I'm going to confirm. So now I know that they're related through the Geisler and the Mox. So I'm going to start color coding. And if you want to learn more about color coding, then I have a whole video about that. But she's related through the Geisler Mox, but not the Geisler Hopis, because that's one generation below. So I go ahead and do the Geisler Mox, and now they're in a group, and I can add a note. So what I like to do is I like to have the ancestral couple's surnames, simply because there's not a lot of repeats. If you have to have a lot of repeats of the surname couples, then maybe put the first names on it. And then I also like to put descendant of. So I know the common ancestor. So which aunt or uncle are they descended from? This one is Mary Elizabeth. Now, if you're using the Ancestry Table Maker to download your DNA matches and do processing, you might want to add even more notes there. I invite you to watch that video about the Ancestry Table Maker and then see some of the notes about people, what they put in those column file to keep track of their notes. Click save. And now one final thing I can do is I could send a message to this DNA match if I so desire and let them know, hey, I've made a discovery, or hey, I have a question for you, whatever. So that's the last thing I do with relationships that have shared trees. Now there's one more thing I want to highlight for our relatives who are second cousins and farther removed, and particularly if they descend from one ancestral couple. We can click on the shared match list. And what's going to happen is my cousin and her DNA match, they all descend from the Geisler Mock tree. We don't have any endogamy in this branch. There's not any intermarriage that we know of. So everybody that matches My cousin and her match through Mary Elizabeth, they're all going to be descended somehow from Joseph and Caroline. So what I can do is now add everybody to the Joseph and Caroline mock group, and it's relatively easy. So let's scroll down to a match that's not in the group, and notice they don't even have a tree linked. There is a public tree here. We might be able to figure this one out. This has a private tree, but all of these people are going to be Geisler mock descendants. So I'm going to click on add to group, and I'm going to click Geisler mock, and then I'm going to go and I'm going to put a check mark next to every single one of these matches. What's really great about these matches, because my cousin took a DNA test, I don't have these matches on my tree, but she does, and they are all related to that Geisler mock. So we're going to add to the group, and then in one fell swoop, I have the color-coded dots for all of these relatives. So once I've processed everybody who has a tree, and I can find the common ancestors, and then I go through and I look at the second to fourth cousins up to 40 centimorgans, shared centimorgans between myself and them, between my cousins and them. I do all of that filtering, and then I assign everybody to a group using the second cousins and more distantly that are from one particular line. Then the next thing I do is I go and try to do specific group research. So what I do there is I click on this filter by groups, and then I pick a specific group. So let's say comfort moots. After I click on the comfort moots, I'm going to get all of the folks that are related to the comfort moots that I've identified. Not anybody who's still unprocessed, but all the ones that I've identified. And now I'm going to go and try to figure out how they are related. So this one is a granddaughter of Allison and Mary Snyder. This one is a grandson of Dorothy Newt. You can tell that I need to go back in and do what I did for this match up here. I need to make mother or father's side and say specifically how related. But now I can start working on these unlinked trees and try to figure out how they're all related to me. In the show notes, I have a little bit more guidance for those who want a step-by-step process of everything I do, as well as some tips on how to go about looking for those living relatives. We like to call it hashtag cyberstalking, but for genealogy. We don't actually want to stalk anybody that is in a not appropriate way. Now, if you're ready for more tips on how to do genetic genealogy research, then I invite you to look at the playlist up above. It has lots of videos from Andy. And if you're ready for something new, check out the one down here. You can't see that. No, you can't see that.